My name is Pei-Lin Yu, and I am an assistant professor of anthropology here at Boise State. My research focus is in archaeology, and I work in a subfield of that called ethnoarchaeology, which is working with living peoples, but thinking like an archaeologist, wondering how living peoples and the ways that they move around their personal spaces, move around the world, how that would affect the way that an archaeological site might look many, many years in the future. It's a fascinating area of research. Most archaeologists work with stuff, objects, stone and bone. You've probably seen pots. Ethnoarchaeologists have to put together a different skill set, usually involved with learning new languages. In my case, learning a language that has never been written down. Doing ethnoarchaeology allows you to become very humble as a scientist, because many times we are completely off base with our ideas as to what artifacts might mean. This little object is really fun to think about. This object is apparently a needle, okay? So this is, it looks very much like a needle, and when I show it to students, they think it's a needle. They think that this is involved with sewing or with drilling clothes for leather. And that's actually a pretty good guess, and I would have guessed this too if I was simply recovering it from an archaeological site. What's really fun about this little object is that it's nothing like a needle and was never used for sewing. This is a ritual object. This is the spine from a stingray's tail. It's used to inject venom into the foot of any unlucky creature that steps on the stingray. And the group of people that I lived with, called the Pumay of Venezuela, used this little object to pierce their tongues. Right up through the side of the tongue bleeds copiously, and your mouth fills with blood, and at that point, you can blow a bloody mist into the sky as an offering to the gods. And I challenge any archaeologist to make that correct inference from the size and shape of this wonderful little object. So ethnoarchaeology is rather difficult. It's rare to find opportunities to live and work with peoples who are living in a traditional non-industrial lifestyle. One of the most exciting parts to me about ethnoarchaeology is that it offers insights into human ecosystem relationships that almost no other branch of science can do. And particularly when we're looking at the origins of our societies, agriculture, and nowadays issues like climate change are all tied up in human ecosystem relationships. And understanding how smaller scale societies have interacted with the environment can offer real insights into how we can solve some of our problems today.